In this video, let's go through calendar sharing. So on the left-hand side here, you can see my calendars. So these are my calendars that belong to me. And down here we have other calendars, which are the public calendars that we can subscribe to. So to add another public calendar, I'm going to press this plus button here. And let's have a look at the calendars of interest. So to subscribe to, let's say, the Christian holidays, let's just tick it here. And let's scroll past sports, just because I'm not into sports. And let's go to other and phases of the moon, and let's tick that there. So now I've subscribed to the phases of the moon and the Christian holidays. Let's go back to see what that looks like. So down the bottom here, you can see that the phases of the moon are in purple. And also the Christian holidays, they will be in green. So for example, the Epiphany there. And if I scroll across, you can see the last quarter moon on Friday the 17th and also the full moon on Saturday 11th, which is Peter's birthday actually. So to see them all in the calendar, they're all automatically ticked, but you can always just untick them and then they'll disappear. So that was the Epiphany and the full moon that disappeared there. So that doesn't actually delete the calendar, that just kind of hides it from view. So let me put them back. And then to unsubscribe, you can just hover over here and then click the cross. And that will unsubscribe you from those calendars there. So that's how to subscribe to a public calendar. So over here, underneath my calendars, is how you can share your calendar with your teammates as well. So I'm going to hover over Joyce and click on these three dots on the end. And then I'm going to go to settings and sharing. So now down here, I can pick get shareable link and share it this way by copying and pasting the link. Or I can also share it by adding specific people by email. And that's how you share your calendar. So once more, you hover over your name, you click on the three dots, click settings and sharing here, and then you can share it by link or you can share it by email. So one important thing to note as well is that if your colleagues haven't shared their calendars with you, then you won't be able to see it in your list here. If they have shared it with you, then you'll be able to see their names underneath your names as well. So that's a little bit about the basics of calendar sharing in Google Calendar.
If you like this content, please hit subscribe and hit the bell notification so you can be notified when we go live or drop new content on the channel. Now, if you'd like to connect with us, hit us up on social media or join our free community group. All the links to that are right below this video. If you'd like to learn more about Google Workspace and the technology ecosystem, you can join our free Genius Academy by transferring your billing across to itGenius. Or you can join a Workspace Basics Bootcamp. Now, if you're a business owner and you're interested in an audit on your technology stack or your Workspace account, or you're looking to do a project in the tech world, well, you can take advantage of our free consultation. And if you need help right now, then consider joining Concierge or taking up a quick fix with our team for professional support for your tech stack.